Welcome back to Nagesh Karasgi or Kids School Children. How are you? All are fine? Okay. I think so. I have given the homework for you. Have you completed? Yes. Now today we are going to learn a new lesson, that is lesson number 6 and open page number 35. The lesson name is The Food We Eat. The Food We Eat. Okay children, tell me, in India different regions of people live. Many different types of people are there in our India, right? So in different regions different types of food is eaten. In different states the different varieties of food is eaten, children. So I will ask you one question. So daily what type of food you eat? Tell me. Yes? Yes children, you eat chapati. Okay. Next, you eat rice? Very good. Yes children. So in my class you all are eating different variety of food, right children? Some are eating chapati, rice, vegetables, etc. So in this lesson we will learn more about food. Okay, now when you go to the south area, to the south, then the people eat most of rice. When you go to the north, the people eat wheat. Why? Because wheat is cultivated more, right children? Now I'll show you some interesting. I brought you something for you. Yes, cereals, spices and pulses. Let us see now. I'll show you first the cereals. Yes, what is this children? Can you see? Yes, this is a rice. These are the cereals, okay? And this is wheat. Yes children, when you go in your kitchen, you can see now these all things. What is this? Wheat, right? And this is jawar. You eat bakri, no? And bakri is made up of jawar. Now these are pulses children. What is this student, tell me? Pulses. This is a dal. These are different variety of pulses. When you go in your kitchen children, ask your mother to show this all type of cereals and pulses. And these also one type of pulses. You know this is a rajma children. What is this? This is a rajma. Now you all know these spices. Have you seen? I think so. At your home, your mother has a masala tiffin, right? The container. These are the coriander, cinnamon, cloves, black pepper, cardamom. Cardamom means this is vilaichi. Yes. And this is black pepper. Black pepper means what? Tell me. What is this? Black pepper, right? This is known as mire. What is this, children? These are cloves. Lavang. I think so in Marathi they say lavang. These are coriander, coriander seeds. This is known as dhane, right? And this is cinnamon stick. Nowadays children, we are drinking Ayush Kada, and this Ayush Kada is made up of this cardamom, cloves, right children? Okay, so you all understood what are cereals, what are pulses and what are spices, right? Now, yes children, lesson number 6, the food we eat. Now children, in this lesson you will learn more about the food eaten by the people from the different regions of India. What the people, they eat from the different areas, right? The common spices like food grains, pulses, vegetables, fruits and etc. Now let us see the transportation of the foodstuff. How the food is carried from the farmers to the market, right? Now we will study more details about this. Yes children, what do you eat at home? Yes, you eat wheat, rice, dal. You eat wheat, rice and dal. Generally, we all eat wheat, rice, dal, etc. Right children? So, it becomes our staple food. Now, what is staple food, you know? What is staple food? You can tell me? Yes, I will tell you. What is staple food? Now children, the food that people in a region eat most, it becomes their staple food. The food is cultivated in that state. That food is known as staple food. Okay children? Next. Now, the food eaten by people from different regions of India. These are the variety of foods eaten in our India. Many different varieties are there, children. See, can you see on this interactive board? Just see, Punjab, North Indian food, South Indian food, and Rajasthan food. The food eaten in different regions of the country depends on the climate and soil of the place. It is dependent upon a soil, children, and climate to grow the grains. Next. Now cereals. These cereals have high level of protein, carbohydrates. These are the cereals. Yes children, these are the cereals. It contains high carbohydrates. And pulses are rich in protein. These are the pulses. And these pulses are very rich in protein. So, we have to consume it daily. Next. See children, I have shown you here some of the cereals. Can you see in this picture? Rice is there, jawar, corn, wheat, maize. These are known as cereals. These are pulses, children. Just now I have shown you these are the pulses, right? The next. Yes, children. Seasonal fruits and vegetables. I will tell you what are the seasonal fruits and vegetables. Seasonal means in a particular season, in that period, the vegetable and fruits are grown is known as seasonal. Seasonal means in the particular period, the vegetables and fruits are grown is known as seasonal fruits and vegetables. Now children, this season is rainy season, right children? Which season is this, tell me? This is rainy season. Yes, we get like apples, bananas, pomegranates, peaches and plums, etc. is known as seasonal fruits. In the rainy season, now we all are getting bananas, pomegranate, plums, bananas and apples in this season, right children? So all are eating fruits now at home? Yes, you have to eat fruits at home daily. At least one fruit you have to take. The next one, these are the vegetables children. See the vegetables, cauliflower, cabbage, corn. These are the fruits. These fruits are cultivated throughout the year. Now let us see the different fruits grown in different states of our country. Children, now let us see, in Kashmir is famous for apples. You all know Kashmir is famous for apples. Apples, cherries and strawberries. Himachal Pradesh is famous for apples. Ladakh is famous for apricots. Nagpur is famous for oranges. Ratnagiri is famous for Alpanzo mangoes. I think all have taken the mangoes, right children, in this season. So many different varieties of mangoes are grown in this area in Ratnagiri. So Kerala and Tamil Nadu are famous for coconuts. Assam and Goa are famous for pineapples. Yes children, the next. See children, the area where mainly fish is eaten. Now I'll tell you in which area the most of the fish is eaten. Now this is the coastal area. This is the coastal area. In this coastal area, the plenty of fishes are eaten. Why? Because we get more there. It is a sea, right? In this coastal area, a lot of fish is eaten as it is available in plenty in this sea. Now see children, where is Kerala? Yes, can you see? Yes, this part, this is the coastal area. Yes, we get plenty of fishes in that places. Yes, we will go for the next. Now the states where wheat is grown, can you see this brown color? Here the wheat is cultivated more in these places like Rajasthan, Uttar Pradesh, Punjab. So in this area, the lot of wheat is grown. It is cultivated in this place. The states where wheat are grown like Rajasthan and Punjab, where it rains very little, wheat is grown well in this climate. Why? Because very less of rain is there, so it is very good for that particular crop. The next. Yes. Now, the states where banana is cultivated. See children, in Maharashtra, Gujarat, Orissa, West Bengal and Tamil Nadu. See children, it is highlighted with a green one. Can you see this? In this area, the most of banana is cultivated in this region, in this place. Okay? Like Gujarat, Orissa, West Bengal and Tamil Nadu. Okay children, the next, the states where rice is cultivated, the state where rice is cultivated, like Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Assam, West Bengal. Now children, can you see this part? Yes, have you seen? It is highlighted with a brown color. So in these places, the most of rice is cultivated. Where it rains a lot, like West Bengal and Assam, so the people of East and South India mainly eat rice. Why? Because most of rice is cultivated in that place. Next. Now even sweets are famous in our India children. Yes, no? These are the sweets. Indian sweets are famous like Rasgulla, Laddus, Gulab Jamun and many more. We all enjoyed sweet in wedding and festivals. Yes children, in weddings and in festivals, we have these sweets, right? These are the different variety of sweets prepared in India. The next. Now children, let us see the way we cook our food in India. The way we cook the food in our India. These are the different variety of oils. These are the different variety of oils. See children, here is sesam oil, mustard oil, sunflower oil and groundnut oil. These are the oils we make the food with. This oils, with this different variety of oils. Right children, we usually cook our food in different types of oil. Now, like sunflower oil, coconut oil, tea oil and groundnut oil and mustard oil. The next. These are the spices children. What are these? Just now I have shown you. These are the spices. Can you see? This is a pepper, cardamom, star, and this is clove, black pepper and cinnamon, nutmeg, cumin seeds. These are the spices. India is famous for spices children. India is famous for spices. Now India food has become very popular worldwide because of different spices. And these spices are included daily in our food items. These all pulses are included in our daily food items. Now let us see this cloves, pepper, cardamom, coriander. The spices add flavor. What this does children? What this does all spices? Yes, tell me. Who can tell? Yes? What it adds to the food? What it adds to the food? It adds flavor. It adds flavor and taste to the food. Without these spices, our food becomes tasteless. Right, children? Yes. Next, transporting food. How the food is transferred from farmer to the wholesaler, and when from wholesaler to the vendors. See, transporting food, the farmers grow crops, right? Who grow the crops? The farmer. The farmer grows crops in their field or farms. The farmer then takes their produce to the wholesaler, market or mandi. Then from here, the vendors, they purchase, they take the vegetables. Shopkeepers and vendors buy these fruits and vegetables, pulses and grains from here. Right, children? We buy food from shops and vendors in the market. Right? Next. Yes, children. Now let us remember these points. People mostly eat food that grows in their region. Our country produces a variety of food grains. Yes, our country produces variety of food grains like fruits, vegetables, pulses, spices and some fruits, vegetables. Next, food in India is cooked in variety of ways. Yes, children. In our India, the food is cooked in variety of ways. Indian food is very popular worldwide. Our Indian food is very popular worldwide. Yes, children. Next. Now, tell me three examples of the following. Spices. Yes. Who will tell me? Yes, it is cardamom, cloves and pepper. Next, vegetables. You have to complete this in your textbook, children, okay, with a pencil. Potato, cauliflower and capsicum. Next, food grains, any three, you can write of your own, any three. Just now I have shown you, no? You can write like wheat, rice, corn, jawar, maize, anything you can write it, children. Now, let us revise once again. Give three examples of the following. Spices, cardamom, cloves and pepper. Vegetables, potato, cauliflower, capsicum. Food grains, wheat, rice and corn. Yes, children. Now next. So open page number 35, children. Open the page number 35. I will show you some pictures here. Can you see these fruits? Fruits, which of them can you name? Can you name these fruits, children? Yes, tell me. Who will name it? What is this? Yes, bananas. Very good. And these are oranges. Yes. And these are grapes. These are pomegranates. And this, what is this, children? Yes, chiku, right. Very good, children. See, children, this is a rajma and these are chickpeas. And they say kabuli chana also for this. These are pulses, children. What are these? Pulses. Harbara dal and this is moog dal. Yes. Now you have to tell me the answers of this. Yes, children? Now match the foods, fruits we eat with the place they are usually found. Okay. Now this is a rice, children. Where the rice is grown, in which region, in which area? Tell me. Who will tell me the answer? Rice is usually grown in coastal area? No. Yes, where it is grown? Let us see. Yes. Strawberries and apples are grown in Jammu and Kashmir. Jawar and Bajra. Yes. It is grown in East and South India. Apricot, Ladakh. Oranges, Nagpur. And fishes, we get fishes in coastal area. Let us see. Yes. See, children, rice is grown in East and South India. Strawberries and apples are grown in Jammu and Kashmir. Jawar and Bajra is grown in Rajasthan. Fishes, yes, fish is grown in coastal area. Oranges are grown in Nagpur and apricot is grown in Ladakh. Yes. Yes, children, wait for a few minutes. I will show you one of the video. Yes.
From the field to the table. India is a vast country where we find diversity not only in language, culture and dress, but in food also. Food is an essential part of one's existence. But have you ever wondered how it reaches your table? Let's unravel the journey of a food grain from the field to our tables. Farmers often till the land by loosening the soil and mixing in fertilizers. Then they sow seeds or plant seedlings. When the crops are growing, the farmers must water the crops, remove weeds and kill crop pests. Once the crops are mature, the farmers will harvest them. The crops are cut during the harvesting season. The cleaned grain is sent to the wholesale merchants in the city. The wholesalers send the grain for grinding to the mills. The ground flour is packed into plastic bags and sealed. The packets of flour are loaded onto the trucks and sent to the shops across the city. We go to our neighborhood grocery shop and buy these packets of flour. We bring it home and use it to make our food. This is the journey of a crop from the field to the table.
Yes, children, have you seen how the food is carried from field to the table? Have you seen, children, how the food is carried from field to table? Right. Okay, children. Now you have to underline the difficult words and learn those hard words. And whatever the exercise are given down, you have to complete those exercise. Okay, children. Now the next session we are going to meet. Bye.